Let x be a number. Translate the English phrase to a mathematical expression, then evaluate the expression for x equals 4. So we want to pay close attention to what the directions are telling us here. It's telling us a lot of stuff. First of all, they give us the name they want us to use for our variable. They've already identified the variable for us. They want us to use the letter x. Next, they're asking us to translate the English phrase to a mathematical expression. So that's the next thing we're going to do. Once we kind of, we know that we're going to need to be using the x somehow in that. Then the final thing that the problem is asking us for is to evaluate the expression for x equals 4. And so each one of these two examples, we're going to have to do a couple of different things. So let's do the first thing, translate the English phrase to a mathematical expression. So in this first problem, the sum of negative 2 and the number. So as we look at this, we say, well, the sum, what does the sum mean? Well, we've certainly seen that on a lot of the problems we've been working in this section. Sum means addition. And what we're going to be adding is negative 2 and the number, which they're telling us should be x. So we want to take the sum of negative 2, so negative 2 is going to come first, and the number, which we're calling x. So I've done the first part. I've translated the English phrase to a mathematical expression. Now we want to do the second part. Evaluate the expression for x equals 4. So we're going to go ahead and leave the negative 2 as it is. We're going to leave the plus sign. But now with that 4, we're going to do our little slip the x out. Before I slip it out, I'm going to kind of put it in a little isolation booth. The x is going to slip out, and in its place is going to go the number 4. And now I have negative 2 plus 4. Well, the signs are different, so we're going to take the difference of 4 and 2 is 2. And because 4 is the larger number part, the largest absolute value, and it's positive, my final answer is positive 2. Or again, we can just go ahead and write 2. So here's where we translated. That was the part where we translated. We changed the English words to math. And then down here, we evaluated. So our next example, we're going to do something very similar. In the next example, it tells us to take the number plus negative 6. Well, we see plus, okay, yeah, plus is something that we understand to be addition. We're going to use addition. The number, again, is going to be x plus, and we're going to be adding negative 6. Well, that problem just pretty much all fills out for me. X plus negative 6. Now this is where we're going to have to use our parentheses, because writing plus minus right next to each other, that becomes very confusing. It's hard to tell that this sign here is making the 6 negative, that is not a subtraction sign. So we want to put the parentheses around that negative 6, x plus negative 6. Now we're going to come back and do the evaluating part just like we did on the other problem. We want to evaluate the expression for x equals 4. So we're going to take our x, and we're going to slip the x out. And in its place, we're going to put down the 4. The plus and negative 6 still stays put. And when we go to do the addition, again, the signs are different. So we take the difference. The difference between 6 and 4 is 2. And in this case, notice the larger number part, the larger absolute value is from the negative 6, since that's the larger absolute value and it has the negative sign, my final answer will be negative 2.